lot of persons have lost a lot of goals because of foolishness. So wisdom is one of the greatest key that can make you to succeed in life. No wonder in the Bible, for those that are scholars of the Bible, when a man like King Solomon was asked by God what he wanted God to do, he quickly said, "I need wisdom." So wisdom is a compass for a durability of future. Wisdom is a compass that brings multiplication. Wisdom is the ability and the capability for you to think and for you to see differences. A person that can see difference where everybody see the same thing is a person with wisdom. Now, wisdom is a greater tool in the life of an individual that creates wealth beyond his or her imaginations. So when you are full of wisdom, you are like a man that is in charge of a territory. Now, that is why sometimes you discover that the lion is not just the king of jungle because he's big. You know that paradoxically speaking, the lion is not big. He's not the greatest or biggest animal in the animal kingdom. We have the elephant, we have the hyena, we have the antelope. But the lion has this wisdom ability to be able to create charge for his territory. So be wise today. So wisdom brings focus in a person's life. Wisdom brings and caution your choices of decision and your choices of conversation. Now, wisdom multiplies your wealth. Wisdom compares your character. One problem we have today is that people are full of charisma. Let me tell you, my friend, charisma can always take people to different places. But what can quickly and always sustain you in relationship, in wealth industry, in finances, in companies, in education, is character. That's why a speaker once said that when character is lost, all is lost in life. So wisdom creates your way to how? Wisdom breaks ideas. Wisdom is like a pregnant mother. Wisdom is like a pregnant mother, expectant mother who is having an expectation. I know the greatest expectation of wisdom is to be able to conceive ideas and bet focus, and in due time produce and manufacture these things. Now, and also let me add here that God is much more interested in your success than you are. Why do I have to say this? Because God is your producer. God made you. But the problem I have today is that human beings are the only creature that has problem with the creator. The fish knows the principles and the laws of the universe, because wisdom is what creates you to understand the principles of the universe. So the principles of the universe work for everybody, whether you're a Hindu, whether you're a Babylonian, whether you're a religious person or not. If you can obey the principles of the universe, you'll be able to succeed. So also let me say something, that God do not bring the check or the amount of money that comes into your account. It is wisdom through your decision that you make that creates your wealth. So your decisions in life decide your worth in life. Worth is not a monetary affair. Worth is not a money word. Worth is a supply word. And the greatest energy that you need for the necessity of creating a worth is wisdom. Now, the difference in season of life through wisdom comes with an instruction through passions of life. So, another thing is that never you put money or never you put your idea or say ideas in the parastatic zone. So before you say your ideas, before you sell out your wisdom, you should be able to make a proper consent and identify if that ground is fertile enough. Now, wisdom creates your wealth. And because wisdom comes with self-discipline, the difference between the present stage you are now and the future is in the wisdom, which is in instructions. And passion is the greatest intimidating factor of life. So self-discipline is the master key to richness or to worthiness. So if you have wisdom to make wealth, and then you apply it with passion, congest it with self-discipline, you're on the key for making the best out of the best. Now, I know a lot of persons will want to contemplate and want to fight on this, because a lot of persons have the mindset or the myopic mindset that God gives wealth. Fine, God gives wealth, but listen to this very carefully. Now, according to Deuteronomy, God said that he is the one that gives the power to make wealth. My friend, what is power? Power in the original word, in the Hebrew context, is the ability, is the capability for you to create something, for you to create ideas, for you to create initiatives. So the world today is no longer, is no longer looking for persons with problems. It's no longer looking for persons just with additional issues, but it's looking for people with ideas to providing solution to humanity. That's why we even have problem with people today. Everybody is struggling for one thing or the other, but those with wisdom, full self-discipline, are always on steady track. And why do I say they're always on steady track? Another thing that creates your wealth is your, what I call, the three C's of life. What are these three C's of life? They are called consistency, commitment, and constancy. A man that is full of vision, full consistency, and constancy and commitment, in addition with three D's of life, which are discipline, determination, and diligence, the person goes far in life. So, as we come to the end of January 2019, and as we make another review of your goal before entering February, I want you to reframe yourself that there are some decisions you need to make for this year before it comes to an end to create wealth. And one of them is wisdom. Another one is self-discipline. Another one is focus. And you should be able to understand this, that do not wait for manna to fall from heaven. Do not wait that money will come into your pocket when you are not full with rivers of wise counsels. Now, successful persons, according to a man called Herbert Gray, successful people are those people that make decisions or habit of daily habits to make things that the unsuccessful people do not do. So your success is determined by the amount of decisions through wisdom that you are able to make. Another thing you must know is this, that a man like Aristotle once said that wisdom is the combination of experience and reflection. My question to you today is, how often do you sit down to reflect about life? How often do you sit down to make experiences? Start from somewhere today and you will never remain the same. Another thing I want to say before I end this is this, that wisdom that creates wealth, according to a man called Napoleon Hill, say that is true self-discipline, and that self-discipline is the ability to make yourself do what others do not do. Albert Einstein added that compound interest or compound wisdom is the most powerful force in the universe. So one of the greatest powerful source, apart from prayers that we pray, fasting, is the ability for you to sit and make decisions through wise counsels.